threat to Ugandans.
Fred Enanga, who released the photos of the wanted suspected terrorists during a press briefing at the police headquarters in Naguru, said whoever comes up with credible information leading to the arrest of the two will be given a cash reward of 20 million shillings. The two are suspected to have been behind the blasts that went off in Chukuba Mutwe, Kansanga and Naweru on Saturday night.
A substantial cash reward of Uganda shillings 20 million awaits any member of the public, including journalists, who avails us very credible information that can lead to the arrest of these wanted terror suspects. And to further remind the public that this investigation, like all the others we have handled in the past months and years, shows that terrorism still exists. So we call upon all members of the public to be vigilant.
Security agencies have since linked the two Saturday blasts to the ADF rebel group that is based in DR Congo. In a statement released yesterday, President Yoweri Museveni said because of the intensity of the UPDF operation Shuja in DR Congo, the groups have resorted to sending in infiltrators to disturb the peace of Ugandans. Among the infiltrators the president mentioned was Abdul Rashid Chote, commonly known as Njovu, who is accused of being behind the recent tourist killings and the two suspects behind the weekend blasts in Kampala. Njovu was arrested, charged with murder and remanded. Enanga advised the public not to approach these two wanted ADF suspects, saying they were armed and dangerous.
We are advising the public not to approach these two wanted ADF suspects because they are armed and dangerous. Our appeal instead is to anyone who believes they have additional information that could assist in this investigation to contact our National Operations Command Center on the usual telephone numbers of 0800-199-699-077-077-600-773 and 0776-999-136.
He said the two want to use improvised explosive devices to terrorize Ugandans. Meanwhile, a total of 3,049 road crashes were registered on Ugandan roads last week, with 64 out of the 379 victims dying, while 315 sustained injuries. The revelations were made by the traffic police spokesperson, Michael Kananura, during the weekly security briefing in Naguru.
Among the fatalities registered, 31 were for motorcycles, that is 12 people were passengers on these motorcycles, 19 were riders, 21 were pedestrians. The causes of these accidents were seen to be improper overtaking, speeding, and following too close.
The police listed the common causes of the accidents as improper overtaking and speeding. He advised motorists to be cautious as they head for the festive season. Report compiled by Sulaiman Motebi for the news.